All right, so today we are reviewing the Pythagorean theorem. So for most of you, this will be a review, no big deal. But for many of you, it's going to be a good refresher. So the idea behind it was last year we taught you Pythagorean theorem in Algebra 1, and we hoped that you mastered it. Okay? If you did not master it, you need to master it this year. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Okay? No ifs, ands, or buts about it. So the Pythagorean theorem is for what? For triangles, specifically which types of triangles? Right triangles. Okay, so is it for the right triangles angles or is it for the right triangles sides? Sides. So it's for finding the measures of right triangle sides. We use the Pythagorean theorem when we need to know a side of a right triangle, specifically right triangles. Questions so far? Okay, so next we want to talk about then, okay, gotta hustle, okay? So remind me, what is the Pythagorean theorem? How do we typically say it? A squared plus b squared equals c squared. Okay? So a stands for what? A leg. B stands for a leg. And c stands for
long.
The hypotenuse. So what I want you to do is I want you to label the legs and the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is the longest side of the right triangle. It is opposite the right angle. Okay? So the hypotenuse is the longest side. It's opposite the right angle. The other two are legs. So what does A represent? One of the legs. What's B? Another leg. And C is the hypotenuse, the length of the hypotenuse. Okay? A and B can be interchanged in this equation. It does not matter. But C cannot be interchanged. C has to be where it's got to be. Okay? So let's look at example one. Okay? Example one. An isosceles right triangle. Isosceles right triangle. What do you mean by isosceles? Two equal lengths, right? So which two have to be the equal sides? The legs, the A and the B. The hypotenuse cannot be the same length as one of the equal sides. A and B are the same length. So we can call it A and A. Those guys are 6 meters long. We want to find the exact length of the hypotenuse. Okay? We want to find the exact length of the hypotenuse. So which part are we missing? The hypotenuse. Which letter do we typically let the hypotenuse be? C. What's our equation going to say? A squared plus b squared, or in this case we have another a squared, right? And c squared. What is 36 squared. 36. So we're going to add 36 plus 36 to get c squared. How much is 36 and 36? 72. If 72 is c squared, square root of 72. The opposite of squaring something is square rooting it, right? So if we take the square root of 72, then we get our c. Slight problem. There's a perfect square in there. What's the perfect square? There's even a bigger perfect square. What's the perfect square? 36. We've got two of those 36s in there, don't we? Yes, 6 square roots of 2. So 36 comes out as a 6. What doesn't have a mate? A 2. So our exact answer is 6 square roots of 2. Can't leave it as a square root of 72 because we spent 4 days learning how to simplify radicals. So we're going to use those skills to our advantage. Here's a visual representation of what's actually happening with the Pythagorean theorem. I have a leg that is 3 in length. Okay? And I have another leg that is 4 in length. And a hypotenuse that is 5 in length, right? So let's see what happens. If I take that leg and I square it, 3 by 3 is how much? 9. Okay, 3 times 3 is 9. What's 4 by 4? 16. The area of a 4 by 4 block is 16. Because in this one we have an isosceles triangle. That's why we've got them both the same length. Okay, it doesn't usually happen that way. This is a special case. Yep, usually A, B, and C. All right, so let's take those 3 by 3, color them in. Got my 9. How much is left? 16. And what's 9 plus 16? 25. So 3 by 3 plus 4 by 4, 9 plus 16 is a total of how many? 25. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. Now just a plus b equals c, right? We have to square the a, square the b, and those two together are c squared. We don't have to do all this to work through. Sometimes some people are visual and like to see it. So far so good? Doesn't help to see it in the representation of area. That's okay. You don't have to look at it that way. Okay? All right. So this theorem only works with what kind of triangles, Jimmy? Right triangles. All right, let's look at example two. Okay? So, most important thing that you have to do is you have to identify the hypotenuse. In example two, which one's the hypotenuse? 13. This one is A, B, or C. This one's your C. It's got to be all by itself, away from everybody else, right? On the other side of the equal sign. It's the longest one. Okay? So what's this going to say in Pythagorean's theorem using x now? And if you even want to skip that step and immediately say x squared plus 64 equals 169, you can start with that step. That's okay, that's showing your work. You just can't have answers. You've got to show some work. Okay? What are we going to do to get the x squared by itself? subtract 64. So what's x squared going to be? But one slight problem. We don't want x squared. We want plain old x. So we have to square root. We have to square root both sides. Does 105 have a perfect square in it? It's ending in 5, so 5 goes into 10 two times, right? Goes into 5 once. And 21 is what times what? 3 times 7. Are there any perfect squares in 105? No pairs, so we write our answer as it was 5 times 21, and 21 is 3 times 7. There are no perfect squares in there, so we just call it square root of 105. That's the exact answer. Okay? No rounding. Questions on this one? All right. Next example. This is what we're going to be doing tomorrow. We'll spend more time with this. Okay? It's going to ask us if side lengths can form a right triangle. Okay, but before we do that, let's find the length of the diagonal. What kind of a quadrilateral is this? A rectangle. We have four congruent right angles. Opposite sides are congruent. So how would we find the diagonal? Which part of the right triangle is the diagonal? This is the hypotenuse. Bless you. So we don't know the hypotenuse. You can let it be x, you can let it be c, your choice. So what's my equation going to say? Gotta have the c squared, the hypotenuse, all by itself, away from everybody else, on its own side of the equal sign. That's the most crucial thing you have to do today. Figure out which is the hypotenuse and isolate it. Okay? What's 4 squared? What's 11 squared? 121 plus 16 is how much? 137. Is there a perfect square in 137? No. So our perfect exact answer is 137 with the square root over the top. Questions on that one? Okay. Now, our theorem says that if a triangle is a right triangle, then a squared plus b squared will be equal to c squared. Leg squared plus leg squared equals hypotenuse squared. And if leg squared plus leg squared is hypotenuse squared, then we know the triangle is a right triangle. It works both ways. It's a biconditional. The converse and the conditional both are true. Okay? So, if I have side lengths 8, 10, and 16, how would I decide if this is a right triangle or not? Gotta do it. First of all, will this make a triangle? How would we decide? We have three sides here. How do we know whether it makes a triangle or not? Add the two smallest lengths, we get 18. And then we ask ourselves, is 18 bigger than 16? And it is, right? So we get a triangle here. We just don't know if it's right, obtuse, or acute. Okay? So what do you think we're going to do to try to figure it out? See if 8 squared plus 10 squared. We're going to talk about it some more tomorrow. What's 8 squared? What's 10 squared? Does 64 plus 100 equal 16 squared? Nope, because what's 16 squared? 256, not equal, right? Not equal, so is it a right triangle? If it's going to be a right triangle, then the leg squared plus the leg squared has to be equal to the hypotenuse squared, right? The longest side here is 16, so that would be our hypotenuse if it's going to be a right triangle. But 64 and 100, 164 is not the same as 256. Okay? So minimal work I want to see on these is 64 plus 100 not equal to 256. Then you can say no. But don't just give me a yes or no answer. Show me some math. Does that make sense? Questions on this? Okay. I think that is all. Oh, last one. Okay, last one. If I need to find the distance between two points, I've been telling you since page 22 and 23 of your book that you had to know distance and midpoint formulas, right?
Yep.
What's the distance formula?
That one.
Okay, so let's use it real quick. Find the distance between these two points. 4, negative 3, and negative 2, 1. Plug it in, make sure you can do it right. Show me. On the quadrilateral test, some of you did not use your distance formula, did not show me that your sides were congruent, so it was a rhombus. Common mistakes. When you subtract a negative 3, it changes 2 plus a positive, right? And when you square a negative 6, what happens? It becomes a positive. What's 36 plus 16? And we have a square root of 52. Are there any perfect squares? Perfect squares. 52 is 2 times 13, and 13 is prime, right? No perfect squares? There's our answer. Square root of 52. Did everybody get square root of 52?
Yep, perfect.
Okay. Square root of what? Oh, 52. I'm sorry. 52 is 26. Thank you. And 2 times 13. We have a pair. What comes out of the radical? The 2. What stays inside? 13. That's our exact answer. Apologies. I'm ahead of myself. Okay? Questions? All right. Here's your assignment.